Hi there, I'm Mary, and today I'll be walking you through how to create your event, the importance of choosing a name for your event, and a tour of your control panel and settings. Creating a free trial is the best way to learn how to use Sched. If you decide to upgrade, all your info will be saved until you are ready to upgrade. Let's begin. First, we will select Create Event in the top right-hand corner. The most important step of creating your event is selecting your event's name. Something to consider when creating your event, I will say Mary's test event, is that you cannot use the same URL twice. Each URL will be unique. The best way to do this while making your event easily recognizable every year is to add the year of the end of the event. So this year I can add 2019, and next year it could be 2020, and then 2021, going on. You will see that my desired URL has already auto-populated. This would be a great time as well to change the URL if I decided I wanted something different. Perhaps I don't want to have Mary's test event all spelled out. Maybe I just want to have MTE for Mary's test event. If you don't know your dates yet, that's perfectly fine. We can easily change dates at later when there are more set for you. I'm going to set hours for this weekend and ending this weekend. And now we can go ahead and create our event. Great, let's take a tour of our control panel. Here you will see that we currently have nothing in our control panel. We have zero sessions, attendees, schedules, responses, or average ratings. This will all populate as we start adding things to our event. First, let's look at speakers. You'll be able to beautifully display your speakers with their photo and bio. You can add them singly, like this. Or if you have five or more to add, I would recommend using the spreadsheet here. If you would like to rename the speaker role to something like presenters, you can do that here as well.
Moving on to our sponsors. Sponsors make your event possible and need prominent real estate on your site. We have four levels of sponsors. If you do not fill a level with sponsors, it will not show in your event. So you could potentially have one, two, or three levels of sponsors. You can also rename the role here. Sessions and attendees. In our next segment, we'll be going over how you can add and import sessions and attendees. So I'm going to skip these tabs. You'll see that you can add sessions with the online form or import them just like you did with speakers and sponsor profiles. More on that in the next video. Messages. There are a lot of important details to communicate to your participants leading up to your event, during the event, and after your event. You can send unlimited emails through Sched. You can email just your attendees, or just the speakers, or everyone at once. There are also a few other handy groups you can target with messages. The welcome invite is the email sent to participants after you add them to your event. It includes a link to log in. You can customize this invite to fit your event here. Two handy emails that are automatically sent to all attendees are the schedule reminder, which goes out each morning of your event with their personal agenda, and their feedback reminder, which gets sent at the end of the day so they don't forget to rate sessions. Now let's move on to settings. You can alter the date of your event here. And please make sure to set the correct time zone for your event so attendees can sync their event to their personal calendar app. Privacy settings for your event can be altered here. And let's go through what each of these mean. Public event with open signup means anyone can create a schedule. Public event with invite-only login means that only those that you have invited can create a schedule, but everyone can see your schedule that you have created and see all the hard work you have put into your event. Private event with login only means that only those with an invite can see your event or create a schedule. Private event with password wall. This will require anyone to enter a general password to access your event, the general password that you set. If we scroll down a little ways, we see session types. This is where we can edit the name and the color of session types once we have added types and sessions to our event. If we come down a little bit further, we can see our content switches. The content switches do mostly what they say on the tin. We can show attendee directory, show attendance list for each session, show a custom page and edit page, show Twitter feed, show speaker names under session titles, show most popular session page, and show uploaded files to logged in attendees only. To come down a touch further, we see speaker tools. By enabling the speaker tools, you are letting your speakers have control over their own sessions and alleviating a bit of your work. Speakers can upload files to their session, speakers can email attendees in their session, speakers can edit their session description, and speakers can see attendee feedback for their session. These are the options available to you in the Engage level packages. If you were to upgrade to a Reserve package, you would also see these control options. Attendance, allow double booking in the same time slot. Freeze attendee schedules from changes. Enable waitlists. And don't show capacity labels when logged out. Now let's have a look at our appearance section. Here is where you can customize your event's appearance with your branding. This will give your event a polished look. You can add a header banner here and add your mobile icon and mobile header here. You can also change the background color of your events page here so that it can match your company colors. At the bottom of this page is where you can upload a map as well. The last thing we'll discuss today are our support pages. You can reach them here. We have built step-by-step guides for most of our common questions and setup needs. Thanks for watching this support video. While you're here, check out some more of our support guides or feel free to connect with us on Twitter at SchedSupport or via email at support@sched.com if you ever have any questions or need help with anything else.